Estamos contentos en este día porque el Señor nos está dando una oportunidad más de poder venir y escuchar de tu palabra, Señor. Gracias por el entendimiento que nos ha dado, Padre. Bendiga a cada uno de mis hermanos con sus manos levantadas. De antemano, usted ya sabe la necesidad de cada uno de mis hermanos, Señor. Concédale el deseo de su corazón a cada uno de ellos. Y a cada uno de mis hermanos que no pudieron llegar, Señor, y que nos miran, que su bendición los alcance donde quiera que estén. En este día queremos ponernos en tus preciosas manos, Señor, para que usted tenga el control completo, que pueda ministrar desde el más grande al más chico, Señor. Padre, deseamos salir mejor de como entramos, Padre. La honra y la gloria siempre será para usted. En el precioso nombre del Señor Jesucristo nos ponemos en tus manos, Señor. Amén. Dios les bendiga, hermanos. Dios bendiga en el precioso nombre del Señor Jesucristo. Los saludamos. Siéntanse en casa. Y es hora de alabar el nombre de nuestro Señor. Oh, mi Redentor. Oh, está contento en esta tarde, hermano? Bendito sea el nombre del Señor.
Oh, God bless you once again.
Dios les bendiga de nuevo.
Now let us open up our Bibles.
Vamos a abrir nuestras Biblias.
In the book of Luke, chapter 16 and verse 16.
En el libro de Lucas, capítulo 16, versículo 16.
To continue with our subject, the mystery of the kingdom of God.
Y continuar con nuestro tema, el misterio del reino de Dios.
And the subtitle is going to be, how do we get into it? This is number 3.
Y el subtítulo es, el número 3, ¿cómo entramos?
The law and the prophets were until John. Since that time, the kingdom of God is preached, and every man presseth into it.
La ley y los profetas fueron hasta Juan. Desde entonces el reino de Dios es predicado, y todos se esfuerzan por entrar en él.
Dear Heavenly Father,
querido Padre Celestial,
thank you once again for allowing us to gather in this place.
Gracias te damos de nuevo por permitirnos juntarnos en este lugar.
Enlighten us with your word.
Y darnos tu palabra.
In the name of Jesus Christ we pray.
En el nombre del Señor Jesucristo oramos.
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Se pueden sentar.
Well, we'll just continue a little more this evening.
Continuamos un poco más en esta tarde.
And yesterday we were looking into this word.
Y ayer nos enfocamos en esta palabra.
That says that since the time that John was preaching.
Y que desde el tiempo que Juan predicaba.
He was preaching the kingdom of God.
Y él predicaba el reino de Dios.
And he told them that the kingdom of God was at hand.
Diciéndoles que el reino de Dios estaba a la mano.
Now we know that Jewish people knew that the kingdom of God was going to be established upon the earth one day.
Y el pueblo judío sabía que el reino de Dios se va a establecer algún día sobre la tierra.
They heard that through the ages by all those prophets.
Y lo han oído a través de las edades por todos estos profetas.
But then, you know, as they kept prophesying, people saw the kingdom of God far into the future.
Y seguían profetizando y el pueblo veía el reino de Dios muy lejos en el futuro.
But now John is proclaiming that the kingdom of God is at hand.
Y ahora Juan estaba proclamando que el reino de Dios estaba cerca.
That's what was making a difference now.
Y es lo que hacía una diferencia.
Because he alarmed the people.
Y alarmando al pueblo.
The kingdom of God is at hand. Finally, it's here.
Finalmente, el reino de Dios ya ha llegado.
Repent.
Arrepiéntanse.
See, they were alarmed.
Estaban alarmados.
So, you know, I guess that they should be happy to know that the kingdom of God was at hand.
Y tenían que estar felices que se acercó el reino de Dios.
Because you want to go to heaven.
Porque tú quieres ir al cielo.
You want to have eternal life.
Quieres tú tener vida eterna.
But then John was not saying, the kingdom of God is here. Just, everybody just come as you are.
Y tampoco dijo él, el reino de Dios aquí está y todos tal como están. Vénganse.
God loves you all. Just come.
Dios les ama a todos. Vénganse.
See, that's how they preach the gospel in many denominations.
Y es así como se predica el evangelio en muchas denominaciones.
Just come as you are.
Vengan así como son.
And sure, the reason they are saying it like that.
Y de seguro la razón porque así lo dicen.
It's because they do not want to offend many different types of people.
Y es que ellos no quieren ofender algunas clases de gentes.
And really, actually, what they're trying to do is to find grace with the gays and lesbians.
Y realmente lo que quieren hacer es encontrar o hallar gracia con la gente lesbiana y los homosexuales.
Because we are living in this very day.
Porque aquí estamos viviendo en este día.
Because Jesus says that in the end time.
Jesús dijo en el tiempo del fin.
You know, the Son of Man was going to be manifested.
Que el Hijo de Dios será manifestado.
And it would be like in the days of Sodom.
Y será como en los días de Sodoma.
And we know that Sodom and Gomorrah was just homosexuality and lesbianism.
Y nosotros sabemos que en aquellos días de Sodoma eran muchos homosexuales y lesbianas.
So now we are living in this, in these days.
Y ahora vivimos en estos días.
So obviously we already have seen it all over the news, on the street, on the schools, at work. There is, this world is infested with homosexuals and lesbians.
Y obviamente lo podemos ver en las noticias, en el trabajo, en las escuelas, en las calles, y todo el mundo está infestado con esta cosa.
And preachers do not want to preach unto them, repent.
Y los predicadores no quieren predicarles, arrepiéntanse.
Because they get offended.
Porque ellos se ofenden.
Now they call it that you are discriminating them, that that's hate, a hate gospel.
Y ahora dicen que los estás discriminando y predicando un evangelio de odio.
Can you imagine? That's exactly it. Don't say anything because they say that's hate speech or that's hate gospel. Right.
Y dicen, no digas nada porque este es un evangelio de odio o un discurso de odio.
Can you imagine?
¿Te imaginas?
And you say, well, nobody's going to pay attention to them.
Y dicen, pues nadie les va a prestar atención.
Oh, you're mistaken.
Te estás equivocando.
They will pay attention to them because even in authority, most of them are in the same boat.
Y muchos, aún en el nivel de autoridad, ellos están en el mismo barco.
All those lawmakers, all those people in the, you know, the White House and in the States, they are also. There's a lot of these perverts in there.
Y hasta en la Casa Blanca, los legisladores y mucha gente, y todo está lleno de ellos.
And that's the reason these laws come to protect those peoples, because they themselves are some of them.
Y por eso hay leyes que los protegen, porque la mayoría o algunos de ellos son así.
So yes, it's getting critical because you might say, oh, who cares about them? There's a lot of them.
Y está crítico, y no podemos decir qué nos importa si hay muchos.
Hey, here's the young little girls, the boys going to school.
Y aquí tenemos a las hermanas jóvenes, a los hermanos que van a la escuela.
Now, haven't you run across this type of people in the schools?
¿No se han topado con esta clase de gente en la escuela?
You have.
Sí lo han hecho.
And none of you can say, well, I know one person.
Y no pueden decir, o dicen, yo conozco una persona.
In my school, I met one person like that.
Y yo en mi escuela conocí una persona así.
No, you've met a few.
No, has conocido varios.
They are all over.
Están por donde quiera.
And even at, you know, you go to any employer, and they are, some of them are in there too.
Y si vas a buscar trabajo, también los encuentras ahí.
So this is getting very disgusting, actually, in a way.
Se está poniendo desgracia.
Muy disgusto, ¿verdad?
Te está poniendo...
O muy feo, ¿verdad?
Muy feo, queda uno disgustado.
Because we are living in the midst of this.
Porque aquí situation. Vivimos nosotros en el medio de ello.
And we need to realize that this is a fact.
Y hay que darnos cuenta que es un hecho.
See? It's not fun.
No es algo gracioso.
Because if we would think, well, just maybe they're here and there, you know, a few of them, but that's not the case. There are so many of them.
Y si pensamos, pues no hay ningún problema, hay uno allá, uno por acá. No, al contrario, hay muchos.
So then, as I said, these churches, the evangelical churches,
y como he dicho, las iglesias evangélicas,
they do not use the word repent.
Ellos no usan la palabra arrepiéntanse.
No, they are saying God loves everyone.
Ellos dicen Dios ama a todos.
Come as you are.
Vengan tal como son.
And I said that I agree that way too. That far I agree. Come as you are.
Y yo sí estoy de acuerdo hasta este nivel que vengan tal como son.
But once you are here,
una vez que están aquí,
you are going to hear the gospel of the kingdom, and that means repent.
Van a oír el evangelio del reino y esto significa arrepiéntete.
Or you are going to go to hell.
Si no, irás al infierno.
That's the Bible, actually.
De hecho, es la Biblia.
But brother, you know, these people will get so offended.
Pero hermano, esta gente se llega a ofender.
And then in those peoples, they're not little churches like this where there's just a couple of dozen people.
Y no hay iglesias así pequeñas donde haya dos docenas de personas.
In those churches, there are hundreds of people.
Y en tales iglesias hay cientos de personas así.
They have hundreds of members.
Y tienen muchos miembros.
So there is going to be more than one pervert in there.
Y va a haber más que un perverso.
If there would be just maybe one, the preacher would be courageous and just preach against it because there is only one.
Si hubiera existido solamente uno, entonces valiente el predicador predicaría en contra de esto.
And most of the members are going to agree with the preacher because yeah, we don't like them, but when everybody is almost that way.
Y la mayoría estaría de acuerdo con el predicador, pero cuando casi todos son así.
The preacher knows that if he speaks like that and it says that it's wrong, he is going to be fired.
Y el predicador conoce si él predicaría así en contra de ellos, él será botado fuera.
They are going to complain and says that man is a hater.
Y ellos se van a quejar diciendo que este hombre es un odiador.
Sí, so they rather says, just come as you are.
Y mejor dicen que vengan tal como son.
God loves everybody.
Dios ama a todos.
And they are happy with it.
Y felices son así.
And the reason they don't change.
Y la razón por qué no cambian.
Is because they are not hearing the gospel of the kingdom.
Y es que ellos no oyen el evangelio del reino.
Because the gospel of the kingdom is repent, which means change.
Porque el evangelio del reino es arrepiéntete y cambia.
Do you see that John the Baptist went out preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God?
Y se dan cuenta que Juan el Bautista salió predicando el evangelio del reino de Dios.
And saying repent.
Y diciendo, arrepiéntanse.
Jesus went out the same way, repent. The disciples went out the same way, repent, because repent is the message.
Jesús salió de la misma manera diciendo, arrepiéntanse, los discípulos también.
So you do not want the people just to come.
Tú no quieres simplemente que llegue la gente.
And stay.
Y quedarse.
And never change.
Y nunca cambiar.
Because then you're not preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God.
Entonces no estarás tú predicando el evangelio del reino de Dios.
They might get offended and they might leave, but you still have to tell them you must change.
Posiblemente llegan a ofenderse y alejarse, pero tienes tú que predicar el evangelio. Cambien.
Let me use that word better because repentance means change, actually.
Mejor usar de manera diferente la palabra arrepentir, quiere decir cambiar, mejor decir cambien.
It's a change of mind.
Es un cambio de mente.
See, they don't want to change their mind. They says God loves everybody.
Y ellos no quieren cambiar su mente diciendo, al contrario, Dios ama a todos.
See, we don't have to really change.
En realidad no tenemos que cambiar.
Yes, they do have to change.
Sí, tienen que hacerlo.
So, they don't want to change their mind.
No quieren cambiar la mente.
And if they don't want to change their mind,
si no quieren cambiar la mente,
they don't change their bodies.
No cambian el cuerpo tampoco.
You cannot change your body unless you change your mind first.
No puedes cambiar tu cuerpo al menos que cambies tu mente primero.
See, they need to see themselves the way they are and says that is wrong.
Tienen que verse a ellos mismos como son y pensar que no está bien.
But see, they don't want to see themselves as if something is wrong.
No quieren mirarse a ellos como que hay algo errado, equivocado.
That's the reason they don't change.
Y es la razón porque no cambian.
Because in their mind, they don't see the wrong image of themselves.
Porque en la mente de ellos no ven una imagen equivocada de ellos.
Actually, they think that the way they are is all right, it's okay.
Y al contrario, ellos piensan que así como son, está bien.
Okay, so, you know, If we had a few of them over here, I would be in trouble already, but thank God that we don't have them.
Estaríamos en problemas teniéndolos aquí, pero gracias a Dios no los tenemos.
But we have to warn you.
Pero hay que advertirles.
Because, you know, young people, you know that they're in school, right?
Porque los jóvenes sabemos que están en la escuela.
And you need to deal with that.
Y tienes tú que lidiar con esto.
And you don't have to offend them.
Y no hay que ofenderlos.
But you don't have to agree with them either.
Y tampoco tienes tú que estar de acuerdo con ellos.
Because they want you to agree with them.
Porque ellos quieren que tú estés de acuerdo.
Oh, no, no. You know, if that's their choice, that's fine.
Si es la escogencia de ellos, está bien.
But we don't agree that with them, that's not right.
Y no estamos de acuerdo con ellos, esto no está bien.
So you says, they say God loves everybody.
Y ellos dicen Dios ama a todos.
Yes, God loves the sinners.
Dios sí ama a los pecadores.
But God does not love their sins.
Pero Dios no ama los pecados de ellos.
That's the reason his own son had to go to Calvary to die for the sins of the sinners.
Y por eso el hijo de él tuvo que ir al Calvario y morir por los pecados de los pecadores.
But those sins cannot be forgiven unless they repent.
Y estos pecados no pueden ser perdonados al menos que haya un arrepentimiento.
See, those people need to repent.
Y esta gente tiene que arrepentirse.
For God to forgive them.
Para que Dios los pueda perdonar.
All right, so you get the idea now.
Y ahora captan la idea.
About what is the gospel of the kingdom of God.
De lo que es el evangelio del reino de Dios.
See, this world wants to dictate people how to live and dress and behave.
Y este mundo quiere dictar a la gente cómo vivir, cómo conducirse, cómo vestirse.
That's the reason you see through TV and movies and everything, you see all those fashions of the world, how they are promoted for the people to follow after those things.
Y podemos ver por la televisión cómo promueven las modas del mundo forzando esto en la gente.
Exactly right. They are forcing this on the people.
Es exactamente, están forzando esto en la gente.
Right? And they do not stop.
Y ellos no paran.
They keep forcing their ideas upon you.
Siguen forzando estas ideas sobre ti.
But they do not like it when we preach what we believe because they think that we are forcing our ideas upon them.
Y no les See? Gusta cuando nosotros predicamos porque piensan que forzamos nuestras ideas en ellos.
No, we preach the gospel and it's up to everybody to accept truth.
Nosotros predicamos el evangelio y depende de la gente que lo acepte o no.
But yet we still have to call wrong, wrong.
Y aún así tenemos que llamar lo equivocado, equivocado.
That's the reason we as Christians, we dress the way we dress, we live the way we live, we talk the way we talk, because that's God's way.
Y es la manera de Dios, y por eso nosotros los cristianos nos vestimos como nos vestimos, hablamos como hablamos.
Sí. We are not here to force you to do that. We're just telling you that that is the right way. That's what God expects from every one of us.
Y no estamos forzando esto. Solamente se lo presentamos como la manera de Dios.
Amen. And if you are a Christian, you will love to go God's way.
Y si eres un cristiano, te encantará ir en la manera de Dios.
That's why God gives us the Holy Spirit, because we agree with Him.
Y por eso Dios nos da el Espíritu Santo, porque estamos de acuerdo con Él.
And when we agree, we obey His word.
Y cuando estamos de acuerdo, obedecemos a su palabra.
See, so we have to agree.
Tenemos que estar de acuerdo.
With the Holy Ghost.
Con el Espíritu Santo.
We have to agree with God's word.
Y concordar con la palabra de Dios.
And that's how we receive the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Y es así como recibimos el Espíritu Santo.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
So anyways, John began preaching the kingdom of God.
Y Juan comenzó a predicar el reino de Dios.
And Jesus said that from that time,
y Jesús dijo desde aquel tiempo,
every man was pressing themselves into it.
Todo hombre se esforzaba entrar en él.
Amen.
Amen.
And I believe that you got the idea yesterday.
Y pienso que han captado la idea ayer.
Because it sounds like it's a good thing to do so, but it's not actually what we thought.
Y Hemos pensado que es una buena cosa hacerlo, pero de hecho no lo es.
Because if Jesus is saying, you know what? What a great thing. You know, John is preaching the gospel and now everybody presses into it. That's good.
Y Jesús nos dijo, oh, qué bueno, Juan está predicando. Qué bueno, hay que seguirle.
It seems like Jesus is saying that. Oh, you know, everybody is pressing it. Man, praise God, everybody is making an effort.
Parece que así lo está diciendo él. Gloria a Dios, todos se están esforzando por entrar en él.
But that was is not what he was meaning.
Pero no fue lo que él quiso decir.
What he meant is that people is trying to get into it in a certain way.
Quería decir que la gente trata de entrar en él de una cierta manera.
But he was not saying that that is the right way.
Y él no dijo que es la manera correcta.
He was only saying, everybody's pressing into it.
Solamente dijo, todos se están esforzando.
Well, we would think, what? But that's good, it's great. No, we find out that it's not so.
Y podemos pensar, oh, esto está bien, pero nos damos cuenta que no es así.
Let me read the other scripture in Matthew 11.
Vayamos a Mateo capítulo 11.
says, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force.
Y el versículo 12 nos dice, y desde los días de Juan el Bautista hasta ahora, el reino de los cielos sufre violencia, y los violentos lo arrebatan.
Oh, again, it seems like Jesus says, hey, now, you know, there's a great revival.
Y parece que él dice, oh, hay un gran avivamiento.
Since John started preaching the kingdom of heaven.
Desde que Juan comenzó a predicar el reino de los cielos.
You know, there's been a lot of violence.
Hay mucha violencia.
And the violent take it by force.
Y por fuerza los violentos lo arrebatan.
See, but we understood.
Y hemos entendido
what he meant. I tell you what, because his disciples,
lo que él dijo porque sus discípulos,
the ones that were following Jesus,
aquellos quien seguían a Jesús,
they heard John,
han oído a Juan,
and John baptized them,
y Juan los bautizó.
And then that's how they went out and spoke to their relatives and says, you know, the kingdom of God is here and the Messiah is here now.
Y es así como salieron y hablaron con sus familias y diciéndoles, aquí está el reino de Dios.
And that's how they became believers in Jesus, because John pointed them to Jesus.
Y es así como llegaron a ser creyentes de Jesús, porque Juan los estaba apuntando hacia Jesús.
Remember when Jesus went by and says, follow me?
Y cuando él dijo saliendo, síganme.
And they did follow him.
Y ellos sí lo han seguido.
Because John had already prepared them.
Porque Juan ya los había preparado.
That was his commission, to prepare the way of the Lord.
Y fue su comisión preparar el camino del Señor.
So when Jesus called them, they were already prepared.
Y cuando Jesús los llamó, han estado ya preparados.
That's why they follow him with no problems.
Y por eso lo han seguido a él sin impedimentos.
Right?
¿Verdad?
So when John baptized them,
cuando Juan los bautizó,
did they go as violent people?
¿Salieron ellos como gente violenta?
Because there was violence going around.
Porque había violencia.
And so that they also were pressing into the water themselves?
Y también se esforzaban ellos al entrar al agua?
No. But let me tell you, I'm going to show you, there were multitudes of people coming to John.
No lo hacían, y les voy a mostrar que había multitudes de gentes que llegaba con Juan.
And you know what happens when there's a lot of people, a multitude?
¿Y saben lo que sucede cuando hay multitudes?
Everybody is just pushing their way through.
Todos buscan y se empujan para poder alcanzar.
That's why they were pressing into that.
Por eso ellos se esforzaban.
They were coming into the water. There was multitudes coming.
Y por eso ellos se apresuraban porque había multitudes de gente.
But they had the wrong motive.
Pero tenían el motivo equivocado.
I can imagine Peter coming into the water.
Y me imagino a Pedro llegando al agua.
And another one pushing back. You get in over there. I was here first.
Y de repente empujando al otro a un lado, diciéndole yo aquí llegué primero.
Because they were scared that the world was coming to its end.
Porque estaban asustados que llegaba el fin del mundo.
And they were lining up to get into the water.
Y se apresuraban al entrar al agua.
And they wanted to go and beat some other people. I was here first.
Y diciéndoles no, yo llegué primero.
Sí. There was violence going on.
Había violencia.
You know, you've seen that. You know, when there is certain holidays.
Y lo han visto cuando hay ciertos días festivos.
Like, I remember one time there was like, I think it was in November.
Y yo recuerdo un tiempo, creo que era en noviembre.
Black Friday?
El viernes negro.
And there was a brother.
Y había un hermano.
He was from another state.
Y era de otro estado.
But he came to our meetings in Georgia.
Y llegó a nuestros servicios en Georgia.
And he says, man, we had to go. And, you know, we put a little tent in the parking lot and we stayed there all night because, man, there were such good bargains.
Y, hombre, pusimos una tiendecita en el estacionamiento porque hay precios muy buenos.
And I told the brother, you mean you used to there all night just to go and get a TV? He says, yeah, man, because, man, they were so cheap.
Y me dices tú, hermano, que has pasado toda la noche ahí por conseguir una televisión.
Now, this was a brother.
Y ese era un hermano.
So he was telling me that, you know, the day before. But he said, man, I got such a good deal, brother.
Y me dijo, hermano, el otro día, el día de ayer, pues, compré yo algo en un buen precio.
And I told him, and there was a lot of people. He said, man, there was a lot of people. You know, everybody wanted to get ahead of one. I said, hey, we got here first. Because you gotta stand on the line.
Y me decía que muchos no querían esperar, y yo les dije, no, aquí estuvimos nosotros primero. See? Hay que esperar en la línea.
Well, guess what? The next day.
Y saben qué, el siguiente día.
Another brother from another state flew in.
Otro hermano voló de otro estado y llegó allá.
And me and the brother that said that he got a good deal the night before we were together, and so this other brother was saying to me.
Y yo y el otro hermano que consiguió el buen precio y el otro.
He says, man, I just, you know, when I left, you know, went to the airport, I saw the stores. Man, people were crazy, really. I mean, all over the place and fighting because they wanted to get, you know, those cameras and TVs and everything. And when they got into the door, they threw down the door, they broke the door, and there was people hurt and everything.
Y hombre, yo pude ver en las noticias la gente peleando en las tiendas, hasta tumbaron la puerta por conseguir ciertos artículos.
He says, man, they're crazy.
Hombre, sí están locos.
And I said, well, this one went yesterday too.
Y este de aquí, pues, se fue ayer.
He says, oh, really? I said, oh, my God.
Y dijo, oh, en serio, oh, Dios mío.
So that's what was happening in the days of John the Baptist. A lot of people came to the banks of the River Jordan.
Y esto es lo que sucedía en los días de Juan. Mucha gente llegaba en las riberas.
Las riberas del río Jordán.
En las riberas del río Jordán.
Repent! The kingdom of God is at hand.
Arrepiéntanse, el reino de Dios se ha acercado.
Oh my God, the end of the world is here. Everybody wanted to get baptized.
Oh Dios mío, el fin del mundo ya está aquí. Todos querían bautizarse.
But think about the disciples.
Piensen acerca de los discípulos.
They got baptized by John.
Han sido bautizados por Juan.
And I don't think that they were fighting on the lines.
Y yo no creo que estaban peleando en la línea.
See, they were instructed by John, and then when Jesus' time came to call them and be with him,
fueron instruidos por Juan, y cuando llegó el tiempo que Jesús los llamara,
Jesus only says, "Follow thou me."
Solamente Jesús les dijo, "Síganme."
And they did not, you know, start getting crazy and coming really violently because they were only just one or two.
Y no se pusieron violentos y enloquecidos porque solamente eran dos o tres.
See, it was John, Peter, they were there fishing. So they don't have to rush because nobody was going to beat them to it.
Y era Juan y Pedro pescando porque no había otra gente para que se los gane.
So they just laid down their nets and just peacefully came and followed Jesus. So there was no violence going on.
Y tranquilamente siguieron a Jesús dejando sus herramientas.
So you see that the disciples did not press into the kingdom.
Pueden observar que los discípulos no
se esforzaron
para entrar en el reino.
They were not trying to take the kingdom by force.
Y no trataron de tomar el reino por fuerza.
Sí. But now let me take you to the days of John when he was preaching in chapter 1.
Vayamos a los días de Juan cuando él predicaba en el capítulo 1.
Or chapter 3, I'm sorry.
Lo siento, el capítulo 3.
So that you can see actually what it means, that verse about violence and pressing into it and stuff like that.
Para que puedan observar mejor estas cosas, la violencia, el esfuerzo.
Jesus didn't say that you have to be violent or stuff like that. He says that people was doing that.
Jesús no dijo que hay que ser violento, solamente dijo que la gente lo hacía.
Amen. That's what Jesus was saying. Since that time, the people is forcing themselves into the kingdom. They are violent. I mean, they're mean. If you're violent, you're mean.
Y es lo que quiere decir, si tú eres violento, eres malo.
Can you imagine maybe some of them were fighting? He says, "I got here first. I told you."
No. Posiblemente algunos golpeándose, diciéndose uno al otro, "Yo llegué primero aquí."
Now, Matthew 3:1 says, "In those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, 'Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.'"
Mateo capítulo 3, versículo 1. En aquellos días vino Juan el Bautista predicando en el desierto de Judea, y diciendo, "Arrepentíos, porque el reino de los cielos se ha acercado."
Now, believe it or not, this is a fact. People, a lot of people become alarmed.
Lo creen o no, mucha gente llegó a alarmarse.
And you know, when people is alarmed, they get full of fear and panic.
Y cuando la gente está así en este estado, se llena de pánico y miedo.
When people is alarmed, they run.
Y cuando la gente está así, entonces ellos corren.
You know, when there is a fire.
Y cuando hay un fuego, un incendio.
The alarm sounds.
Y timbra el alarma.
And people is alarmed.
Y la gente se alarma.
And they walk towards the exit very calmly. You know.
Y entonces caminan muy calmos hacia la salida.
You know, brother, there's a big fire, you know, the alarm. Let's go. I got to go and drink some water because it's getting a little hot, but we'll go in a little bit.
Hermano, hay aquí un gran incendio, pero calmados, voy a tomar un poco de agua y salimos después.
No, you know what happens when people get alarmed? They jump into each other when sometimes they trample onto others and people have died like that. Yeah.
Y saben lo que sucede, siempre la gente se amontona y hay atascos y la gente muere de este modo.
I've heard news where people just, they say, "What happened? There was two or three people that died." It's because a lot of people, when they went into a stampede, they were stomping on top of other people and they got asphyxiated and stuff like that.
Y la gente llega a morirse así cuando se amontonan uno encima del otro y llegan a morir asfixiados.
So now that gives you the idea of the words of Jesus. The violent take it by force. Now you knew that they were alarmed.
Y ahora entendemos mejor las palabras de Jesús cuando él dijo que el violento lo toma por fuerza.
They were alarmed.
Estaban ellos asustados.
So that means that they were not just walking really cool. They were running, they were pushing, they were shoving, and they were getting angry with people because they were alarmed.
Y esto quiere decir que la gente no estaba en un estado de calma, sino al contrario, estaban asustados.
No, think about it.
Piénsenlo.
When you get alarmed,
cuando tú te asustas,
you panic.
Te vas a panicar.
O se llena de pánico.
O te llenas de pánico.
You get really scared.
Y llegas a estar muy asustado.
And you know what happens when you get into a state of panic?
Y sabe lo que sucede cuando llegas a este estado de pánico.
When you are afraid.
Y cuando tú tienes miedo.
Your mind doesn't work properly.
No trabaja tu mente de una manera apropiada.
So therefore you don't think properly either.
Y tú no piensas bien tampoco.
And if you are misbehaving or throwing punches at somebody, you don't care even if you're a brother or a sister.
Y desobedeciendo y tirando golpes y a los hermanos sin importarte si es hermana.
Can you imagine? It says, you know, the brother and the sister, and they were fighting. How can they fight? They are brothers and sisters. Well, they were afraid. They were in panic.
Y llegamos a pensar cómo pudieron los hermanos o hermanas golpearse, pero cuando entras en este estado de pánico, si lo haces.
So I'm telling you then what?
Y les digo entonces qué.
When you panic,
cuando te llega este estado de pánico,
you are going to do things, but in the wrong way.
Vas a hacer cosas, pero del modo incorrecto.
That's the reason we should never become afraid of anything.
Y por eso no hay que temer nada.
Because when you allow yourself to become afraid or become in panic or alarmed,
y cuando llegas o permites tú que te entre el miedo o que tengas miedo,
you do things that later on you know that was wrong.
Y tú haces cosas que después te darás cuenta que no eran correctas.
Let me give you an example.
Y les daré un ejemplo.
Because I guess if I don't give an example, people just don't get it.
Y supongo que si no les doy un ejemplo, la gente no lo capta.
Let's say the two girls like a boy. Or maybe we should change that.
Digamos que a dos muchachas les gusta el mismo muchacho. Mejor lo cambiamos.
All of a sudden, a boy comes in for the first time and the two girls look at the same boy and they like him.
Y de repente entra un muchacho y las dos muchachas les encantan.
And somehow one or both of them get alarmed because this is, what if she beats me to it?
Y de repente una se asusta pensando, ¿qué tal si la otra me gana?
And they begin thinking out of fear.
Y comienzan a pensar teniendo miedo.
And they will do the wrong thing.
Y van a hacer lo incorrecto.
They become upset at one another.
Y llegan a enojarse una con la otra.
Because now they're jealous about each other.
Y ahora tienen celos.
It's not going to be for you. He's looking at me. No, he's looking at me. He don't like you. No, I know that he likes me.
No es para ti. Me está mirando a mí. No, no, no creas. Me está mirando a ti, no a ti.
And if things get heated, then now they want to throw punches too.
Y si se empieza a calentar la cosa, comienzan con los golpes.
And if you cannot throw punches, you just don't want to talk to one another.
Y si no puedes tú golpear, entonces dejas de hablarle.
And then you see them and people wonder, how come they don't talk to each other? No, they don't get along. They don't want to talk to each other. There is a reason for everything.
Y hay una razón por qué no se hablan, aunque la gente se pregunta por qué no se hablan.
Right.
¿Verdad?
And you know what? You know who loses quicker?
¿Y saben quién pierde primero?
The one that gets scared the most.
Aquella quien se asusta más.
If you think I gotta do something because they're gonna beat me to it.
Y si piensas, oh, tengo que hacer algo, si no me van a ganar.
You know what happens?
¿Sabe lo que sucede?
What you fear,
lo que tú temes,
comes to pass.
Te va a suceder.
And then you blame the other person, you know, because she was flirting and everything, but he wanted to come to me, but she was doing this. No, it's your fear that brings things about.
Y aunque culpes a la otra persona, fue tu propio miedo quien te trajo esto sobre ti.
But it's always very difficult for people to understand that it's your own fears what brings to you what you don't like.
Y es difícil para la gente que lo entienda, son tus propios temores, es lo que te trae sobre ti lo que a ti no te gusta.
So I give you an advice, when you see something like that and then you says, man, you know, even if it's two boys and then you say, we see a girl.
Y les voy a dar un ejemplo, un consejo, cuando dos muchachos ven a una muchacha.
Don't compete.
No entren a competir.
Don't get scared.
No se asusten.
I gotta do something because if I don't do that, he's gonna beat me to her.
Voy a tener que hacer algo. Si no hago algo, el otro me va a ganar.
Well, if you are fearing that, that's exactly what's going to happen.
Si tú temes esto, es exactamente lo que te va a suceder.
So what do we do then?
¿Y qué hacemos entonces?
Don't compete. Says, Lord, I like her. Or I like him. If it's for me, praise God. And if it's for my brother, praise God too.
No voy a competir, no. Señor, pero si es para mí, alabado seas tú, si es para él, bendito Dios.
Thy will be done.
Que sea hecha tu voluntad.
As it is in heaven, so in the earth.
Así como en el cielo, tal como en la tierra.
That's true, brother.
And you know who gets it?
¿Sabe quién lo obtiene?
The one that operates in the principles of God. Lord, let thy will be done.
La persona quien opera en los principios de Dios.
Sí. So let's not try to be afraid and trying to chase somebody, try to beat everybody else to it.
No tratemos de perseguir a nadie o tratar de ganar a alguien.
Well, that's only one example. I got to get off of it. But I want you to give you an idea how things operate, okay?
Es solamente un ejemplo y voy a apartarme del tema porque es solamente un ejemplo.
Did you understand this example?
¿Entienden este ejemplo?
It happens, I'm telling you.
Y sucede y les estoy diciendo.
And if you do not walk confidently and allowing the will of God to be done on earth in you.
Y si no caminas de manera confiada o confiadamente y permitir que la voluntad de Dios sea hecha en tu vida.
You are going to be frustrated.
Vas a ser frustrado.
You're going to be upset.
Vas a llegar a ser enojado.
And you're going to be blaming somebody for beating you to things.
Y vas a culpar a alguien porque te ganó en ciertas cosas.
But actually, you were the one that set that law in place.
Pero fuiste tú quien activó esta ley en el lugar.
That what you fear, you attract.
Lo que tú temías, lo has atraído.
See, we're the one that set those laws in order.
Y es somos nosotros quienes ponemos estas leyes.
But we tend to blame.
Y tenemos tendencia de culpar
others
a otros
for what's going on wrong in our lives.
Lo que no nos va bien a nosotros en nuestras vidas.
I hope you get this point.
Espero que capten este punto.
We'll go into this a little later into more examples.
Y vamos a entrar en esto después con más ejemplos.
But now let me go to verse 5 in Matthew so that you can see it, what I'm saying.
Vayamos al versículo 5 en Mateo para que vean lo que yo digo.
Then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan.
Entonces salía a él Jerusalén y toda Judea y toda la región de alrededor del Jordán.
You see how many people came to him?
¿Y ven cuánta gente llegó a él?
Or you didn't get it when I read it.
¿O no lo han captado cuando yo lo leí?
Then went out to him. I mean, he was in the river. He was just baptizing Jesus over there in the river.
Y hermano Jesse, ahí estaba él bautizando en el río.
And you think that he might be waiting, I hope that somebody comes, man. I haven't baptized one in a long time.
Y piensan que él estaba esperando ahí, pensando, oh, espero que alguien llegue para que los bautice.
All of a sudden, he was baptizing one, and when he looked.
De repente estaba él bautizando a uno, y cuando vi.
He probably got scared, says my God.
Y de repente, posiblemente se asustó.
He says, he went out to him, Jerusalem, Judea and all the region about Jordan.
Y cuando él bautizaba salía él Jerusalén y toda Judea y toda la región de alrededor del Jordán.
Oh, his preaching really caused a commotion.
Y su predicación realmente con los conmovió.
Everybody was thinking this is the end of the world. I want to be saved. I want to accept Jehovah as my savior.
Y todos pensaban es el fin del mundo y quiero yo ser salvo y aceptar a Jehová como mi salvador.
Imagínense, hermanos, que el día que ayer bautizamos a Cecia, ¿verdad, hermana?
Just imagine, brothers, yesterday we baptized sister Cecia.
Bien tristes, bautizamos uno por allá cada vez. We baptize one here and one there.
Bautizamos uno aquí, uno por allá.
What if we were baptizing one and all of a sudden, oh, people all around the church and everybody wanted to bang into the doors and coming in? We would have been scared, you know, the gangsters and somebody are breaking into our church. What's going on?
¿Qué tal si de repente la gente al bautizar a la hermana por alrededor se apresuraban a entrar para ser bautizados?
No, isn't that realistically? We don't be scared, Jesse, that all of a sudden people breaking into the church and we don't know where they're coming from? What's going on?
¿No es algo esto realístico, hermano Jesse, que la gente se apresure para llegar a ser bautizados?
Can you imagine and we turn around and say, what do you guys want? We want to get baptized and everybody jumping into the little thing and says, wait, by one by one.
¿Y qué tal si ellos de repente quieren saltar en el bautisterio para ser bautizados? Y nosotros, no, espérense, uno por uno.
But you know what happens in our situation? We baptize one and says, anybody else?
Y sucede en nuestra situación, bautizamos a uno y después, ¿hay alguien más?
Even yesterday I didn't even do that because I said, there's no one else.
Y ayer no lo quise hacer porque no había...
Sometimes you invite others. Is there anybody else? I said, we already know everybody's baptized, so forget about it.
Y mejor olvídese porque sabemos que todos son bautizados.
Do you get the point?
Captan el punto.
No, you might think it's funny, but are you watching the real picture of what's going on in that day? I'd love to see it. How was things really were going?
Parece que esto es algo gracioso, pero a mí me encanta mirar las cosas tal como son.
So there is John, and then people all over the place are coming. This is multitudes of people.
Y esto es Juan, y por todo alrededor hay multitudes de gentes.
And were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins.
Y eran bautizados por él en el Jordán, confesando sus pecados.
I can see Peter. Peter, are you repentant? Do you repent of your sins? Yes.
Y puedo ver a Pedro, oh, ¿te arrepientes de tus pecados? Sí.
May God have mercy on me, and he would baptize, you know, Peter.
Oh, que Dios tenga misericordia de mí, y él bautizando a Pedro.
Next, there comes little John.
El siguiente, ahí viene el pequeño Juan.
Are you here to confess your sins? Because they said that they were confessing their sins.
Aquí estás tú para confesar tus pecados, porque nos dice aquí confesando los pecados.
I am guilty of many things.
Culpable soy de muchas cosas.
I confess my sins. May God forgive me.
Confieso mis pecados, que Dios me perdone.
And then John would baptize him for the forgiveness of his sins.
Y Juan bautizándolo a él por el perdón de sus pecados.
Everything was really nice and cool.
Todo estaba bien suave.
But watch what the scripture says.
Pero mire lo que la escritura dice.
But you know now what happened now when it says but.
Pero ahora sí conocen cuando pone esta palabra aquí.
But,
pero,
but when he saw a few,
cuando vio a pocos, no,
many,
que muchos,
you know, John is baptizing,
Juan bautizándolos,
but when he saw many of the Pharisees,
pero cuando vieron a muchos de los fariseos,
and Sadducees, everybody was coming, the Baptists and the Pentecostals, everybody was now, you know, their brothers now.
Y a todos los fariseos y saduceos, y todos ya son hermanos ahora.
You know when the towers fell in New York?
Y cuando cayeron las torres en Nueva York.
Even Buddhists and Hinduists and Baptists and even Billy Graham and all the preachers were together. Now they love each other now because they were so afraid because they think that the end of the world was here now.
Y ahora todos los budistas y los de otras religiones hasta...
budistas, hinduistas.
Hinduistas y todos se juntaron porque eran hermanos.
How many remembers that?
¿Cuándo se recuerdan esto?
Well, I was watching the news.
Yo estaba viendo las noticias.
A big stadium.
un gran estadio.
And the mayor Giuliani of New York was right there in the platform for a bunch of preachers, and Billy Graham was there.
Y el alcalde de la ciudad y Billy Graham en la plataforma, ahí estaban los dos.
And then a Hinduist was there, and another guy with a big robe and stuff like that, all a weirdo was right there too.
Y ahí estaban todos los raros juntos.
You know, they don't like each other, actually.
Y de hecho, no se quieren uno al otro.
But there was so much panic when those towers were brought down.
Pero hubo tanto pánico cuando se derrumbaron las dos torres.
All of a sudden, they forgot their differences.
Y de repente se olvidaron de sus diferencias.
And they were hugging each other. We are brothers and we'll, oh God, help us. Be merciful to us now, see?
Y ahora se amaban uno al otro, abrazándose, clamando, oh Dios, ten misericordia de nosotros.
Exactly what's going on over here in John.
Y es exactamente lo que le sucede aquí en Juan.
But when he saw many of the Pharisees,
pero cuando vio a muchos de los fariseos,
and the other ones too, the one that hated them,
y a los otros quien los odiaban.
Because they were enemies, actually. Sadducees and Pharisees didn't get along.
Porque ellos no se llevaban bien, los fariseos y los saduceos eran enemigos.
But all of a sudden they come together now. They're brothers and sisters now.
Y de repente aquí se juntan ambos grupos y son hermanos y hermanas.
Now Pharisees and Sadducees were together and coming to his baptism.
Y ahora se juntan los fariseos y los saduceos viniendo a su bautismo.
And he said unto them,
y les dijo,
oh generation of vipers,
oh generación de víboras.
Now they saw them actually, and they were so many.
Y los vio y eran muchos.
And the Pharisee wanted to beat the Sadducee to go into the water, and the Sadducee wanted to beat the Pharisee to get into the water. Everybody wanted to get into the water first.
Y los fariseos querían ganarse a los saduceos y al revés, y todos querían entrar al agua.
Can you imagine?
¿Se imaginan?
That's the reason Jesus or John saw both of them.
Y esta es la razón porque Juan vio a ambos.
And they were actually being violent to one another. That would be not courteous. And brother, you can go first.
Y no eran amables y eran violentos. Oh, hermano, usted pasa primero.
Oh, no, Mr. Pharisee, you first going.
No, señor fariseo, usted primero.
Oh, no, Mr. Sadducee, you go first. I can wait. They were not doing that.
Oh, ellos no hacían esto.
See, John saw them and said, you hypocrites.
Y Juan vio esto y les dijo, hipócritas.
Generation of vipers, who had warned you to flee from the wrath to come?
Víboras, ¿quién os enseñó a huir de la ira que vendrá?
Now that's the scriptural part. Wasn't he John hitting the bullseye? He was telling me, you guys are so alarmed thinking that this is the end of the world. And you come as hypocrites to get baptized because you want to be saved. But you are hypocrites because you really don't love Jehovah.
Y aquí estaba Juan pegándole justo al blanco, reprendiéndoles a ellos, diciéndoles realmente, verdaderamente no aman a Jehová.
You are alarmed because you don't understand what I'm preaching.
Están asustados o tan asustados y no entienden lo que estoy predicando.
Because if you understand the gospel,
porque si entienden el evangelio,
this is not going to happen overnight. The end of the world is not coming overnight.
Y esto no sucede de noche a la mañana. No sucede así.
Haven't you read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, where it says that I would come and prepare the way of the Lord?
¿No han leído en el libro de Isaías cuando dice que yo vendré para preparar el camino?
So there's going to be a period of time.
Habrá un periodo de tiempo.
But if you are coming so violently like that, when you find out that it's not going to take place right away, then you're going to go back into the same thing again.
Y see? Cuando se darán cuenta que no sucede de inmediato, regresarán a sus caminos como han estado antes.
Bring forth, therefore, fruits meet for repentance.
Haced pues frutos dignos de arrepentimiento.
They mean they were coming into the water not because they were repented. They were coming into the water out of fear.
Quiere decir que llegaron a las aguas para bautizarse no por el arrepentimiento, sino por el miedo que tenían.
Would you like to stand for a moment?
Gustan ponerse por un momento de pie.
I'm closing.
Estoy cerrando.
But I want you to rest a little bit.
Quiero que descansen un poco.
So I believe that we understand very good now Luke 16:16, where Jesus says, from the days of John the Baptist now, you know, everybody is pressing into it.
Y yo pienso que ahora entendemos muy bien Mateo 16:16, cuando Jesús dice que todos se esfuerzan por entrar en él.
Everybody tried to get in, you know, by force.
Y todos quieren entrar por fuerza.
And that's not the way God wants you to come into the kingdom, by force.
Y esto no es la manera como Dios quiere que entres en el reino por fuerza.
Do you see it?
¿Lo ven?
Okay, so now I think that we can leave that to the side. Now we understand.
Y ahora supongo, pienso que podemos dejar esto a un lado.
So then, if we are supposed to come into the kingdom,
y entonces, si queremos entrar en el reino,
now we know that we don't have to be alarmed.
Y ahora sabemos que no hay que estar asustados.
We don't have to be scared.
O asustados.
We need to know that God is calling us to change our ways because we are going to go into a righteous kingdom.
Hay que conocer que Dios nos llama para entrar en un reino de righteousness.
De justicia.
De justicia.
Because Jesus says, seek ye first.
Porque Jesús dijo, buscad primero.
The kingdom of God.
El reino de Dios.
And its righteousness.
Y su justicia.
So if you are going to come and live in a kingdom of righteousness, you have to give up your way. You need to repent first. See?
Y si quieres vivir en un reino de justicia, quiere decir que tienes tú que soltar tus maneras.
That's the reason I said.
Y es la razón porque he dicho.
That some of us, you know, through the years, and this is everywhere.
Y algunos de nosotros a través de los años y es por donde quiera.
Sometimes we develop ill feelings once to another one.
Y desarrollamos malos sentimientos en contra de alguien.
You know, I don't hang around with her because there is something about it.
Y yo no me junto con ella porque hay algo.
I don't hang around with him because I don't like it.
Y yo no me junto con él porque a mí no me gusta.
Do you know that there's things like this in church?
¿Sabían que hay cosas así en la iglesia?
In every church.
En cada iglesia.
Oh, I don't like that brother over there in Chicago.
Y a mí no me gusta tal hermano en Chicago.
And a brother in Chicago says, I don't like that brother in Aurora.
Y el hermano de Chicago dice, no me gusta tal hermano en Aurora.
They can allow jealousy.
Y pueden permitir que los celos.
Or bitterness.
O amargura.
Or any wrong emotion.
O cualquier otro sentimiento.
To be part of their lives.
Que sea parte de la vida de ellos.
Do you think that you are going to come into a kingdom of righteousness in that way?
¿Piensas tú que vas a llegar a un reino de justicia de esta manera?
Maybe we go to church and we behave the best we can, but still that's not the way to come into the kingdom.
Posiblemente vayamos a la iglesia de esta manera, pero no es así como entramos en el reino.
We need to change.
Ahí tenemos que cambiar.
We need to change our mind. If you don't like the brother, there's got to be a reason why you don't like the brother.
Si a ti no te gusta el hermano, tiene que haber una razón porque a ti no te gusta el hermano.
And you know what is the reason we don't like somebody?
¿Y sabe cuál es el motivo, la razón por qué no nos gusta alguien?
Because we have perceived that person in the wrong way.
Porque hemos percibido a esta persona de un modo incorrecto.
So basically, you are victim of your own perceptions.
Básicamente eres víctima de tu propia percepción.
I don't like him because of this. That's your perception.
Y a mí no me gusta el hermano por esto.
I don't like her because of this.
A mí no me gusta ella por esto.
That because.
Y este por qué.
Is your perception.
Es tu percepción.
And you know what? When you repent.
Y sabes que cuando te arrepientes.
Then you change your perception.
Y tú cambias tu percepción.
Then you say, you know what, after all, maybe he did it because of something else.
Y te darás cuenta, oh, posiblemente él hizo esto por tal razón.
You know, last night I told you that the Lord helped me change my perception regarding my dad.
Y les conté anoche como Dios me ayudó a cambiar mi percepción de mi papá.
I had bad feelings toward my dad.
Tenía yo un mal sentimiento. Uh-huh. Un mal sentimiento con él.
I resented him for some things.
Lo resentía él por cosas.
And that's because I was perceiving him in the wrong way.
Y es porque lo percibía yo a él de un modo incorrecto.
But when the Lord told me that my perception was wrong,
cuando el Señor me dijo que mi percepción era equivocada,
He gave me the right perception of it.
Me dio la percepción correcta
And
de
when
ello.
I saw the right perspective of it,
y cuando vi la perspectiva correcta de
my
ello,
mind changed.
Mi mente cambió.
And then instead of hate,
y en vez del odio,
instead of bitterness,
en vez de amargura,
I felt love and compassion.
Sentí amor y compasión.
Automatically. What did it?
Automáticamente, ¿qué hizo?
A change of perception.
Un cambio de percepción.
And a lot of people cannot forgive people because they perceive them wrong.
Y mucha gente no puede perdonar a la gente porque los percibe mal.
And they think that the problem is the other people.
Y ellos creen que el problema es la otra parte.
And it isn't. It's your own perception. So people.
Y no lo es tu propia percepción, no la gente.
And until you change that perception, you're never going to love them.
Y hasta que no cambies esta percepción, nunca los vas a amar.
Until you change that perception, you're going to blame them.
Hasta que no cambies tu percepción, seguirás culpándolos.
For anything that makes you feel bad.
De todo lo que te hace a ti sentirte mal.
No, you want to know what makes you feel bad?
¿Quieres saber lo que te hace a ti sentir mal?
The brother?
El hermano.
No, it's your perception.
No, es tu
your brother.
Tu percepción.
Yeah, bro, but he did that.
Hermano, pero me hizo esto.
Yet you have a wrong perception because you don't even know why he really did that.
Y tienes una percepción equivocada porque ni siquiera sabes por qué hizo él esto.
Maybe he did it innocently and didn't even know.
Posiblemente lo hizo de manera inocente sin darse cuenta.
Maybe he don't even know.
Posiblemente ni lo sabe.
But you perceive them wrong and you are having a bad feeling towards him.
Y lo has percibido mal y tienes mal sentimiento con él.
How many understands this? This is very powerful, I'm telling you.
Y les estoy diciendo, es muy poderoso cuando cuántos los entienden.
You know which way we come into the kingdom now. So, you know, the way God says, that's how we need to come into the kingdom.
Y es así como Dios nos dice, es la manera como entrar en el reino.
But I'm going to leave it right here because I didn't even get to the next scripture again.
Y lo voy a dejar aquí porque ni siquiera alcancé la otra escritura.
Because I was going to go into the scripture that I left behind yesterday, you know, about going and become a little child.
E
like
iba
a little
yo
child.
A entrar en la escritura que la dejé pendiente anoche, ¿cómo es que hay que ser un infante?
Well, for some reason, it just, God did not allow it tonight. I'll do it for Sunday.
Por algún motivo, Dios no lo permitió en esta noche y lo voy a hacer el domingo.
Amen. But you, do you see the picture of everything? So Jesus is telling us that is wrong the way people is trying to approach the kingdom of God.
Y podemos ver el cuadro mejor, Jesús diciéndonos que es la manera equivocada como la gente quiere acercarse al reino de Dios.
But you cannot enter into the kingdom like that.
Y tú no puedes entrar en el reino así.
So how do we get into the kingdom?
¿Y cómo entramos entonces en el reino?
Jesus says that unless we become as little children.
Y Jesús nos dijo, al menos que llegamos a ser como pequeños infantes. Pequeños infantes.
Well, you know that word, you know, because the Bible says that they were infants.
Y dice que eran infantes.
But then it also says that they were little children.
Y también dicen que eran niños pequeños.
So you're an infant is one that it's just a little baby.
Y un infante es un pequeño bebé que tú cargas.
Because you carry him, he's maybe, you know, it's just a baby.
Y cargándolo porque es simplemente un bebé.
But some of them are just little children. They, you know, they still walk even though they're little.
Y aunque otros son pequeños niños, pero sí pueden caminar.
But you know, that's actually what we want to see.
Pero es de hecho lo que nosotros queremos ver.
What is it about those little children?
¿Qué es tocante a estos pequeños niños?
And Jesus wants us to become the way they are.
Y Jesús quiere que nosotros lleguemos a ser como ellos.
So we'll see it, okay?
Y lo vamos a ver.
Let us pray.
Oremos.
Dear Heavenly Father,
querido Padre Celestial,
again, we thank you once again for this portion.
De nuevo te agradecemos por esta porción.
We are having a real good look into the gospel of the kingdom of God.
Tenemos una muy buena vista tocante al reino de Dios.
We are understanding the words of our Lord Jesus.
Y entendemos las palabras del Señor Jesús.
And how the people were approaching the gospel.
Y cómo la gente se acercaba al evangelio.
And they think that they can come in any way and they still will get into the kingdom.
Y ellos piensan que se pueden acercar en cualquier modo y pueden entrar en el reino.
But it's not the way they thought.
pero no es del modo como lo han pensado.
You thought the disciples which way we can come into the kingdom.
Le has enseñado a los discípulos el modo como entrar en el reino.
And that's the approach that we must take.
Y es el acercamiento que debemos tomar.
To get into the kingdom.
Para entrar en el reino.
So for this portion tonight, we thank you.
Por esta porción en esta noche te agradecemos.
And now we worship you and we praise you.
Y ahora te adoramos y te alabamos.
Because you are worthy.
Porque tú digno eres.
We thank you for everything, Lord.
Te agradecemos por todo, Señor.
In the name of our Lord and Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ.
En el nombre de nuestro Señor y Salvador, nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Sickness, oh sickness. fuerte aplauso al Señor en esta noche, hermanos. Aleluya. Amen. Why won't you sing that song? Victory is mine. Amen. Well, I woke up this morning. I didn't have a doubt. I knew that the Lord will bring me out. So I got down on my knees. I said, Lord, help me please. I got up and sang the shout of the victory.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. Aren't you thankful this evening?
Agradecidos en esta noche.
I'm thankful for so many things.
Agradecidos por tantas cosas.
And we should be always be willing to express it.
Y siempre hay que estar dispuestos en expresarlo.
You know, that's one of the things that St. Paul told us to do.
Y es una de las cosas que el San Pablo nos dijo que hagamos.
To be grateful to the Lord.
Grateful,
agradecidos.
Agradecidos con el Señor.
Yeah, he said, you know, to be thankful for everything.
Y nos dijo que hay que ser agradecidos por todo.
So, actually, that's one thing that we give thanks to God for everything.
Y de hecho, damos gracias a Dios por todo.
But, you know, the best way to give thanks to God.
Y de la mejor manera para darle gracias a Él.
Is not to say it.
No es decirlo.
Is to feel it.
Es sentirlo.
When you feel it.
Cuando lo sientes.
He knows you meant it.
Y Él sabe que tú lo quieres.
So, when I, ever, anytime that I want to say, Lord, thank you, I want to feel that.
Cada vez que yo quiero decirle, Señor, gracias, yo quiero sentirlo.
Because we do not want to repeat just out of habit. Oh, the Bible says this, repeat that.
No queremos solamente repetir por costumbre, o la Biblia dice esto.
No, we want to mean what we said to the Lord.
No, al contrario, queremos que tenga un significado lo que le decimos al Señor.
And believe me.
Y créanme.
The more you think about things to be grateful.
Si piensan más en las cosas que hay que ser agradecido.
And you keep thinking and feeling it.
Y sigue usted pensando y sintiéndolo.
The anointing of the Holy Ghost is going to be there.
Y el ungimiento de Dios ahí va a estar.
Because when we are thankful.
Cuando somos agradecidos.
We can feel him right there.
Ahí mismo lo podemos sentir.
Because he loves to hear you when you give him thanks from your heart.
Porque a él le encanta oírte a ti cuando le das gracias de tu corazón.
And you know what?
¿Y saben qué?
I like it too because I like to feel his presence.
Y a mí me gusta también porque yo quiero sentir su presencia.
I like to feel his anointing.
Quiero yo sentir su ungimiento.
You know, and every time that I feel it, I know that he's pleased.
Y cada vez que yo lo siento, sé que él agradado es.
And then he's pleased, I am grateful.
Y entonces si él es le agrada y yo también estoy contento.
And if I'm grateful, he is pleased.
Y si yo le agradezco, él está contento.
Amen. So we are going to close the service also now.
Vamos a cerrar el servicio ahora.
I just want you to keep my wife in prayer.
Quiero que mantengan a mi esposa en oración.
You know, before I came to the service,
antes de venir al servicio,
she had to go out to the store and she fell.
Tuvo que salir a la tienda y se cayó.
And I think it was a little more serious than what you think.
Y creo que es algo más serio de lo que piensan.
Because she was in pain and then her daughter had to take her to the emergency at the Cruz Roja.
Estaba sintiendo dolor y su hija tuvo que llevarla de emergencia al hospital.
To the Red Cross.
O con la Cruz Roja.
So basically after they did some tests and look into the x-rays, they found a fissure in the ankle.
Y después de haber hecho análisis y los resultados de los rayos X, han encontrado un hueso quebrado.
So they had to wrap, you know, her leg and told her now she can go to, you know, to a regular doctor, to one that can look into that and see what he's going to do. This is maybe he's, of course, he's going to probably put a cast on you.
Y posiblemente tiene que hacer algo más y la mandaron con otro doctor especialista.
But all we have to do is ask.
Todo lo que tenemos que hacer es pedir.
And believe that God can heal that fissure.
Y creer que Dios puede sanar esta herida.
Amen.
Amen.
God will do it and it'll be like if nothing happens.
Dios lo hará y será como que nada hubiese pasado.
And if we get together in one heart, I mean, God answers prayers.
Y si nos juntamos como en un solo corazón, Dios contesta oración.
Amen. So let us pray and just keep in prayer so that she will be all right.
Oremos y mantenerla en oración para que esté bien.
Amen. Dear Heavenly Father,
querido Padre Celestial,
things happen for a reason.
Cosas suceden por una razón.
And we are not supposed to be shaken or moved.
Y no tenemos que ser movidos o sacudidos.
Because you told us, fear not.
Nos dijiste que no temamos.
All we must do is only believe.
Todo lo que hay que hacer es solo creer.
Because we know that all things are possible if we believe.
Porque sabemos que todas las cosas son posibles si creemos.
So, Father, we come in the way of prayer.
Padre, nos acercamos en oración.
Asking that you may restore my wife's ankle to a normal condition again.
Y te pedimos que restaures el pie de mi esposa a una condición normal.
We ask that your Holy Spirit,
y que permitas que el Espíritu Santo,
may touch that affected part,
que toque esta parte afectada,
and heal it and restore it 100%.
Y que la sanes y la restaures a 100%.
And now we accept it.
Y ahora lo aceptamos.
We commit her into your hands.
Y la encomendamos a ella en tus manos.
We accept what we have asked for.
Y aceptamos lo que hemos pedido.
And we thank you for that.
Y te agradecemos por ello.
In the name of our Lord and Savior.
En el nombre de nuestro Señor y Salvador.
And our healer.
Y nuestro sanador.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
El Señor Jesucristo.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amén. Gracias, Señor.
Amen. You are dismissed. Just shake hands with one another.
Son despedidos. Se pueden saludar los unos a los otros.
Amen.
Amén. Amen.